Do what? From the heart. Why not?
Oh, yeah.
I don't even remember this one.
You won't. Wait till you hear
it. Is there a new title for this one?
Nope. This was just like that typical angst song about people not believing in what you're doing, you know, and just shitting all over your dreams, and then you get to live them, you know, which I'm obviously I was still carrying around a little bit from the years we had put in to get to that point. I remember Dan working on this song in your downstairs bedroom at your mom's house and going over the chord progression, like, no, do this one, Dan, you know, and every time it starts, it sounds like
Ozzy
Osbourne.
We talked about adding that.
Yeah.
And I remember the bridge, coming up and switching the chords in the bridge while I kept the lead line going.
And I remember there was a little bit of friction about the chorus beat. Did it end up going blop, 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 or is it just blop, blop? I forget how it went. I do not even know. I feel like I remember wanting that downbeat to be like,
you know, we had a harmony here we didn't put in, actually. Here it is.
It's just a unison. They never believe them, they just tore them down. We will rebuild them from the start. We will rebuild them from the heart.
And harmonies here that are not in, actually. Let's see what they sound like.
These were not in the final mix.
From the heart. Yeah, those weren't in the mix.
So, because they're too good.
Yeah.
I never know when to step away from the vocal painting when coming up with harmonies. I'll just keep going and going and going, and somebody literally has to go like, dude, that's enough. That's too many.
And I think we did that at the end. We put them in there. Let's see.
From the heart. From the heart. From the heart. From the heart. From the heart.
When you get a second, could you go to the chorus and solo the guitars? Because, some, you know, one thing that I've always kind of been... I'm playing notes in there. But as you listen in the song, you don't hear it, you know? When you're listening to the record, you just hear power chords, you know? Which is something I was always, not bummed on, but bummed on, you know? Like... that it just didn't cut through better, yeah. In my guitar performance, I hear the stiffness of it. Like, what I'm hearing right here, I go, I would never play it like that now.
No.
Not being as prepared or familiar with overdubs at times, I don't find that I can play them as good as I can play them later.
After you practice.
Yes. And so in this case,
I remember you would have to go home and we wouldn't do them right away. You would go home and practice.
But there's also at that time too in my life and as a musician, there was simply just some shit that I didn't see the way I see it now. I don't hear it that. I don't hear it stiff like that.
That's a good sound. What
but,
is that?
But about? I do now. I do like that song a lot, and there's things about it, like what you're singing and shit, that I really like with the chords that we're playing. But then there's also moments of it that I go like, fuck, I wish we would have, or I would have executed my performance slightly different, you know, in hindsight, but
whatever. Making a record moment in time.
All right.
Yeah.